Very good afternoon, my dear student. So, as I am discussing about the list under the introduction to Python according to the new CBSE curriculum, so in this particular section of list implementation, I am going to show you much more implementation of the list in a different ways. Now, see here what has been given. Updating and manipulating list. Updating and manipulating lists. So what is updating? Updating means that you give something new, and manipulating means you want to change, you want to manipulate. So we can update or manipulate the elements of the list. That means what are the elements in the list that can be manipulated, that can be updated. And we can slice them. Slice means to make it apart as per our requirement, as per our requirement that we want to show it, we want to present it. Like see here, I have taken one list. In this particular list, what you can see that I have taken English, Hindi, 1997 and 2000. What are they? They are these two. These two are your alphabetic values. And these two are the numerical values. So alphabetical value, you see what I have done, I have given them with a single inverted comma. Okay, and numerical value, I haven't introduced any single inverted comma. So this is the particular thing what we find it, that this particular structure, this particular frame can be done in a list. Okay. So printing the value, what I have said, print value, what to value, that the value in the position number 2. So value available at index 2. What to print? Print the value that is available in the list 2. That means that is available in the position 2. Isn't it? That to print. Next, what? List 2 colon 3 equals to what? What it will going to show? That 2001 and 2002. List 2, what it will show? 2001 for a single item updated. Okay, now print, what to print? Print the new value available at index 2. Print, what to print? New value available at index 3. So the value available at index 2 previously, what? This one. Why this is 2? Because this is what position? This is 0th position, isn't it? This particular position is what? This is the 0th position. Next, what? This is the, this particular position is what? This is the 1st position. Okay, so this is the 0th position. This one is the 1st position. Now, this one is what? This one is the 2nd position. Okay, this one is the 2nd position. And this particular one is what? This is the 3rd position. Okay, so this is what their positional address. These are the positional address of each of the variables. So, each of the variables, the positional address what it has. Now, what I have done? I have inserted some values there. So when I have inserted some values, what we can find it, now the value position has been changed. So as the value position has been changed, what it has given, now the new value for index 2, that means the place 2 or address 2, whatever you say, place 2, address 2, index number 2 is what? The new value that has been entered. What is that? 2001. For index 3, what the new value has been entered? 2002. So 2002 was the new value that has been entered here. Okay, so this is how the thing will going to work. So in this particular thing, what one more thing that I am going to show you in this today's discussion, that to add the item, how to add the item. Add means append. So this is an append function to be used. Okay, we can use the append function in a list. Where to use? use the append function in a list to add the item. So if you want to add the item, we can use this particular append function. Like what has been done, see here, I have taken list, and in a list I have given two values, 1 and 2. So after giving these two values, what I have done, print. What to print? List before appending. That means before I append, before I add some values, what is that? Now what I am appending, list.append 3. Now I am appending one new value, that is 3. So print the list append. What to print? The after appending, what will be the value? Clear? So before appending, what was the list value, 1 and 2? Because when I have started the program, what I have given there, I have given the value 1 and 2. But after appending, when I have used this particular function, what is the function? This is one function. Okay, this is one function of the list. FUNCTION. This is the function in a list. So what function is that? This function is called an append function. Okay, so when you are using the append function, this particular append function help you to do or to add the value in the existing list. Okay, so you can add the different numbers. If you want to add a particular character value, like some name, some place name, that also you can add. So all these things can be done with the help of this append function. So in this particular content, here I will going to show you one way that we can manipulate the list. So how we can manipulate the list? See here, I have taken list 1. In this list 1, what I have taken? 20, 25, then one name is there, that means combination of some alphabets, then again some numbers, then again the combination of some alphabets. Okay, now in the list 2, that what I have taken? I have taken here one combination of alphabets, then some numbers. So those two things, those two parts, what has been taken, what we find it, that now I am printing it. What I am printing? I am printing the list 1. Okay, now I am doing some manipulation. What I need to see? I need to see the 0th position. Then I need to see from first position to third position. Before of the third position. When we say third position, that means not third position. Remember it, before of the third position. If I say fourth position, then before of the fourth position. If I say 10th position, then before of the 10th position. That means up to the 9th position it will going to do. Okay, next what I have given, print list first, list 1 first. Then what I have done, print list 2 into 3. Then what I have done, I have added them. So different place, what are the place? If you see it, then there will be 0. It will start from 0, then 1, then 2, then 3, then 4. Isn't it? This way the value address will be. And if you go from the back, that means from the down, back side, it will be what? Minus 1, then minus 2, then minus 3. Okay, so this way there are different number and the different alphabets what has been given in a list, they will going to have their value in this way. This position is at present 0. Okay, 0th position. But if I start it from here, if I start counting it from here, then the position will going to change. That means what will be now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. That means this position is at this moment, from the back side, what it will be? It will be minus 6. Okay, so this is how you can see how the position value is. Now let's see what is the outcome of this particular program. So this is the outcome of the particular program. It's what I say, that in the first case I want to print only the list value. See, only the list value has been printed. Then I want to print the 0th position. What I said, this was the 0th position, isn't it? So this is the 0th position, so 0th position value has been printed. Now what I said, from first to third, that means this is first, this is second, this is third. So first to third means before of third, that means two value has been printed. isn't it? So same way, the position value, what has been mentioned? 1. So this is the first position mentioned. Now what I said, list 1 into 3. Into 3 means thrice the value will going to print. So this is the first part, this is the second part, and this is the third part. Okay, then what I have said, that I need to concatenate. I am concatenating the both the values. So concatenating, here I have concatenated the first part and here I have concatenated the second part. That means list 1 and list 2 has been concatenated. Okay, this is how we can manipulate the list. Let's see the next program what is waiting for. So in this particular program, what you can see that I have used the different type of word. What are the word that I have taken here? The name I have given, see, I have changed the name. Can you notice it? Did you notice it? So this is the particular thing. One I have given sub, one I have given add sub. So that means I can give the name as per the requirement. But again, I am saying name should not be any pattern of keyword, any pattern of reserve word, isn't it? That should not be. Okay, any pattern of function name also cannot be used. So these are the things, those are the values I have added. Now what I said, print sub 1, print sub 1 colon 2, then print sub 2 colon blank, isn't it? Then print colon 2, then add sub into 2, then what? Sub plus add sub. Okay, so this is the manipulation what we find that the thing can be done. Okay, these are the manipulation that the thing can be done. And in this particular manipulation system, what I am doing here, I am bringing the particular form. Okay, I am bringing the particular form. So this particular form, that what we are doing, we are working with the particular format that is available. And in this particular format, we can find it that there are the different type of what sections has been taken. Yeah, there are the different pattern of sections has been taken to implement on those two lists. This is the one, list 1 and this is the list 2. Okay, just I have changed the name here. Previously, you have seen that list 1, list 2 I have given here, or list 1 has been named. Now I have just changed the name. So based on that, the thing will going to work. Okay, now let's see what the output is. This you can find it that there are the different type of output is there. Okay, what I need to print, what is my printing that options I have given. First I have given to print all the values in the particular first list, what was the sub. Then I need to print the first position value. So first position value has been printed. After I printed the first position value, what I print, I printed this maths and English, that means 0th and 1. So what I need to do, can you say? Yes, obviously, from 0, from that position to the second position. Second position means before of the second position. You have seen, first there is a blank, that means what it is written like this, then blank, then two colon sign. Colon sign is there, like this colon is there, then two. Okay, so colon two. So this is this second, similarly in this case also what? From where to where it will going to start and where to end. Similarly, that pattern, this is for this one. Okay, so this is the one thing that is there. Next one, you can find it that there are the different pattern of the thing has been given. That means how many time I need to print the first one I have given into two. Into two means this is one set. This can be said as an one set and this is an another set, isn't it? These are the two sets are there. Next, what we can find it, the two things are concatenated, they are joined. So this is what the different form of manipulation. We are manipulating the list. We can manipulate the list in a different way. Okay, so as we are manipulating the list in different way, then we can find it that each of the manipulations, how we are manipulating them, we are manipulating them using their place value. We are manipulating them using or calling those lists, isn't it? So as the different pattern of manipulations are there, as the different types of manipulations are there, each and every pattern of manipulations, you must notice them very carefully, that when we are manipulating the list, we are very cautious that up to how much. First consider is up to how much we need to print. Okay, what we need to print, from where we need to start the printing. Okay, from what we do and how we want to activate that particular printing. What the information we want to give to our machine, isn't it? Which place value, that means that about the place value, regarding about the place value, we should be very aware of. Okay, based on this place value, we will going to do the work. Clear? So this is what about our today's session. Thank you, students. Thank you, students. So I am ending up the session here.